How's it going, Teal Boys? It is time for the national championship. Oh my gosh, we face off against Texas, who came into the playoffs as the 3 seed. They're 13-1. They had to beat, I don't remember who came before Oklahoma, but they had to beat Oklahoma in the semifinal round. So they had a rematch to get to this championship game, as did we, as we defeated Penn State. Absolutely decimated them. They were a 99 overall team. So is Texas, though. And the Longhorns have a terrifyingly efficient offense, averaging over 500 yards per game. Defensively, they're not terrible. Actually, they're pretty dang good. So when you look at the numbers, you can see why Lee Corso would favor the Longhorns to win this one. But, I mean, I know how we rock. We're a good team. There's a reason we're 14-1. There's a reason that we are number one in the country. And for that reason, I think we're getting the win here. Texas, we'll just have them wearing the aways. We could maybe go with a throwback, but this is the national championship game. Teams aren't wearing weird uniforms when you're traditional at heart. And for us, we've earned our way to our standard home uniforms. Got to get that brand recognition out there. 99 overall again across the board for the Longhorns. We've got a 93 overall with a 97 offense and a 92 defense. And I'm hoping that it's enough in this game. Again, statistically, these guys look impressive as heck. Third in points on offense, first in yards, 46th in passing yards, but 5th in rushing yards. On defense, they're 10th, 8th, 12th, and 23rd. I mean, they pick up most of their yards or a majority of their yards running the ball, but we also have the number one rush defense in the country, so maybe a chance for us to stop them there. So it's kind of their offense against our defense, and our offense actually scoring more points per game, although I think that includes just total points in general. So our special teams definitely boosting that number, but this one looks like it should be a very interesting matchup on paper. Their top players for next year, a kicker, a right guard, and a punter. That's good news for us. Just means that it's just weird, you know, not skill players that we have to worry about as much. Injuries? Oh, ho, ho. A right end is questionable, and there are two linebackers out for this game for sure for the Longhorns. I think that we just got to go in here and see if we can call ourselves national champions. So here we are, the Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta, for all the marbles. Can we win this one? Texas is gonna go with tails, and they will lose the toss, so we will just elect to kick this one off. No win today, as we are in the dome. And as Frederick gets this one underway, we are 4 quarters away from a potential national championship. We know that Texas is going to bring everything, but the special teams keeping them inside the 15 to start this game. Definitely concerned about the defenses. Texas will open up, bringing a man in motion. Looks like it's going to be a quarterback keeper out towards the edge, and somehow we're there for the tackle. It seemed like he had some space, but only got a yard. And I'm curious to see, in these situations, will they run it or they pass it? They step back, another designed quarterback keeper, the draw that time. It's quickly 3rd and 7. So just maybe some questionable play calling to start this one off for the Longhorns. They're going to step back to pass a man open, but we're going to get there in time to prevent him from picking up the first down. Just, again, not throwing that one far enough. We see these teams do that so often, and it's going to force Texas to bring out the punt team. So Marquise will get the ball into his hands fairly early in this game, and we'll see what we can do on the return. Oh, absolutely nothing. We broke a tackle. That should have been a lot less than 11 yards, but we'll take it. A 3-and-out is about as good as we could have hoped for on that opening drive for the defense, and now this first possession for the offense. Starting with good field position, what can we do? A run up the middle for Braden Bennett. Actually works pretty well. Turns out to be 7 yards on that one. Just like the last game, I want to be running the ball as much as possible. So a read option on 2nd and 3. Sees Radon Randell with a little bit of space. He makes a man miss, and then we're going to try to avoid the contact and get out of bounds. It's a 14-yard pickup, but oh no, that's CJ Beasley down. So it seems like early on we could be down a running back. Thank goodness we have a good third stringer. But Brain Bennett maybe getting the majority of the reps now, throwing the quick timing route to Mobley, and Tyson's able to get us 9 more yards. So we're moving down the field very efficiently right now. Radon has his first pass complete of the day, and now on 2nd and 1, we'll run a little counter, get Braden up the middle, and make sure that we move the chains and get another first down. Kind of looking for Logan Malden on this one. We'll bring Marquise in motion and passing on first down. Malden might be open. He's not going to hold on through the contact. Good hit from the defensive back to break that one up. CJ Beasley just out for a quarter, has a bruised ankle. You got to imagine he's a senior. He's definitely going to want to play through whatever little bit of pain he has from that one. So good news that we'll have our, 97 overall back in the game. But on this coaching decision, we will let him sit for a little bit. I don't see the need to potentially re-aggravate the injury, so we'll let him rest up while Brayden gets some early reps. But on 3rd and 5, we're going to pass, and we're going to throw an interception. Oh, Tyson didn't run the route exactly how I had expected, so the DB's just right there for the easy pick. Lawrence Edwards comes down with it. And we're going to start this game off with an early turnover. Obviously not optimal. How about on this first down, kind of expecting the run to the quarterback, keeping it on the option, but pitching it out, and Gilliam gets a first down and breaks a couple of tackles before going out of bounds and picking up 18 yards. A lot of interesting looks in the running game so far from the Longhorns. This one's going to be handed off, but Will Phillips is there to meet Gilliam in the backfield for a loss of 2. If the offense isn't going to get it done, we will have to rely on the defense to win this game for us, and so far they're doing a pretty dang good job. We've got them in another third down situation here, and I'm going to expect the pass on this one. They will step back to throw. Somebody's got to be open. That's bad coverage from me, and we don't get this stop quite in time. Pretty favorable spot from the refs. That's just bad user on my end, but it's enough to get Texas across midfield with another first down. I'm bringing pressure on this one. We got to the quarterback, but just missed him somehow. He did throw it away, so we didn't get hurt too badly. Definitely going to expect a run on this 2nd and 10, as that just kind of seems to be their mantra. No, a play action. Cale Mackey needs to get this tackle, but he can't. Cantrell breaks it. So instead of a 3rd and 10, or maybe worse, it's a 3rd and 4 for Texas. We're going to hope for the best. Bring in a little bit of a blitz on this 3rd down. We'll see what we can do if we can get there in time. Not going to be a screen. Guys open on the corner route. And it's another 1st down for the Longhorns. Certainly expecting a run on this play. 1st and 10, handoff. Find some space. Gets 4 more yards. I like the stops on 1st down. Those ones hurt, though, when they get 4. Trying not to bring too much pressure, but at the same time, I think that we need to try to get to this quarterback early, because we've already seen he's a little bit of a threat running the ball and definitely passing. Once again, however, we do have this Longhorn team in a 3rd down. They're in field goal range. I imagine they're going to step back looking to throw, and they threw at my user, and I covered it well, but we can't get the tackle. So it is yet another 1st down. Another 3rd down conversion, and they keep this drive alive, marching ever closer to the end zone. Another run, this one met in the backfield by Emmanuel Bush for a loss of 1. We get them to the 2nd and 11. It kind of seemed like maybe we had shaken up the running back on that play as well. And on this 2nd down, the starter comes back in. They're going to step back looking to throw. Man wide open. That time we do get the tackle in time, but that's 3rd and inches at the 5. We're going to have to sell out to stop the run here. Bring in pressure with the safeties. Can we get there in time? Man in motion. Oh, we just barely missed the running back. He's going to break a tackle, and Texas gets on the board first in this national championship game. It's 7-0 to the Longhorns. So we will get a chance to return the ball, but with 5 seconds left in the first quarter, it seems like we're going to be trailing as we head into the 2nd. You never know with Marquise. Things could happen. And Jackson, oh, so close to breaking that one off for a big one. He did manage to get us to the 26, so a worthwhile endeavor, as we will look to throw On the final play of the first quarter, maybe we go for a little bit of a scramble. Maybe we just throw it over the middle. And, well, we found Malcolm Williams, but it's only for 2 yards because the ball was thrown well behind him. So at the end of one, we have had opportunities to be in the lead in this one. We just couldn't quite get it done the first time on the offense, and the defense just could not get a stop on third down. Definitely no need to panic just yet, but I will get worried if we can't do something big on this drive. You know, a three and out or something would be terrible here, as it is third down now. We're going to try the inverted veer on this third down, hoping for the best. Radon, oh my gosh. I feel like I read that one properly. The dude just covered both of us off, so it is a three and out. We're going to have to punt it away on fourth down. At this point, we're just hoping for a nice cheesy bounce off of the punt, and there it is. Oh, wow. It's going to go for a touchback. That was one heck of a bounce. All right. Got a call on the defense here to get a stop for us. Bringing a little bit of pressure on this first down. They're going to make a man go in motion. Quarterback keeps it. And we'll pull him down from behind at the line of scrimmage. I've seen that play a couple of times now. I'm just hoping they don't have a wrinkle that they can add into that where the quarterback doesn't keep it, because we might sell out for it. Quarterback keeping it again on the option here. Cale Mackey. Again, we can't get the tackle. Luckily, on the stiff arm cheese, we knocked Tony McBride out of bounds. But it's now third and four. They'll step back to pass. Can we get there with Smith? No, the pressure isn't there. Don Riley gets the tackle, though. A yard short of the line to gain. And we will get off the field. The defense able to hold that time. And Marquise with an opportunity to return the punt. I don't like to rely on his abilities, but sometimes that feels like it's the only option that we have. Decent start to the return as he gets to the corner. And he gets us across midfield, so good field position for the offense to work with on this drive, and we need points no matter what. We should be able to kick a field goal in the long 40s, maybe a 50-yarder if we get the right amount of power, but I can't rely on that, as we're going to go quickly a throw to Braden Bennett. They were bringing a little bit of pressure, and that's good for 5 yards. Radon, 3 of 5 through the air for only 16 yards and a pick is not too great, so maybe trying to rely on the running a little bit more here as we do get 3 more and it's a third and short for us now. Let's keep this on the ground though with the read option. Radon has some space, gets hit, picks up 3 though, and we can keep this drive alive for a little bit longer. Oh, this might be the one. I'm sending Marquise deep. No deep safety on his side of the field. His man's pressed up. They're not bringing... No, they are bringing some pressure. And this is a terribly risky pass, and it's picked off. Uh-oh. I would go so far as to say that my decision-making is not super great right now. This one, a run up the middle. Defense gets a stop for a loss of a yard. We're trying to bring decent amount of pressure on first down. It's been working pretty well. On this one, I'm expecting the quarterback to keep it. No, he does hand it off this time, and it's Durham Finch out on the edge to drop the wide receiver for a loss of 2. That brings up another third down for us to defend against. I'm going to use Rasheed McCray here, see if we can get some pressure on this quarterback on the third and long. Pressure not quite coming. He throws over the middle, and it should be a stop. Nobody can get the tackle. Oh my gosh, what are we doing? How many third downs are we going to allow the Longhorns to convert before we figure it out? This one, a pitch out towards the edge. We're there with Cale, and he can get the tackle. If our defense was just a little bit better on third downs, this would be a tie game at 0-0 right now. But they're just struggling too much. Inside 2 minutes left in the half. And Texas starting to move on this drive. That pass puts them across midfield and stops the clock, so they won't have to worry about timeouts. Kind of expecting a lot of passing at this point. Bringing the safety blitz. We get the quarterback to scramble, but we get the sack anyways. And it's a loss of 7 with the clock. No, they took it their first timeout. Now, can we just get the stop? 5 wide for the Longhorns on 2nd and 17 as they throw short over the middle. And we get the tackle. They get 6, but it's still behind the original line of scrimmage. And now on 3rd and 12, I'm going to, again, use a McCray, try to get a little bit of pressure. We're in the 3-3-5 right now. Pressure gets to him, but look at a man wide open. Aaron Jenkins is nowhere to be found. And again, a third long, and we can't get the stop. This is abysmal. First down again for these guys. We're gonna try the man defense a little bit. And what's it? It's another 7 yards. This is just about worst case scenario at this point. Gonna bring a lot of pressure. Second down, try to get the blitz there. It's not gonna work, and they're gonna get the first down, but have to take their second timeout with a minute and 21. Quarterback, just one incompletion so far on the day. As again, no, they're actually gonna go with the draw play, which will have the clock running, and a loss of two there. It's honestly kind of crazy to me, the difference between our first down defense and our third down defense. On first down, we drop them for a loss all the time. On third downs, we give them whatever the heck they want. And there's another broken tackle and a first and goal now for the Longhorns. That was an incredibly risky run call there. They're going to step back to pass here. Quarterback's going to scramble. He's stuck in the pocket, stumbling forward, though. He got a yard out of the play. Clock's still moving. I'm taking the timeout with 43 seconds. Can we bring some pressure here? Second and goal. They're going to step back to pass. Quarterback had to roll outside the pocket, and he gets hit as he's throwing. So an incompletion and third down. A chance to hold them to a field goal here. I'm going to bring some pressure again. You know what? I'm bringing a lot more pressure. I feel like they could run here. They don't run. There's a man wide open. They didn't throw the right route in the corner of the end zone. They had one. Instead, they throw short, and we do get the stop. It's fourth and goal. And with 36 seconds, we take our second timeout to stop the clock. We'll see if they make this. I assume they will. They're going to be up 10 points. But we've got 33 seconds maybe to get a couple of those back. Just got to hope that Marquise gets us a good return here. There's no way I'm leaving him in the end zone, even if this one is 9.5 yards deep. We bring it out. There's no blocking whatsoever, but Marquise gets the corner regardless. He gets out of bounds across the 35. Well, we've already thrown two interceptions in this game. Let's hope there's not another one, as we are definitely throwing a lot. Deep balls only on this drive. This is a risky one. Malden can't come down with it. Good defense from the safety. On this second and 10 with 23 seconds, we'll again step back. There's Marquise. He makes a man miss, and Marquise Jackson might be gone. He has the speed, and with 15 seconds left in the half, he goes 64 yards to the house. The incredible little step back cheese is enough for us to finally get on the board. Just absolutely broke that defensive back's ankles. Oh my gosh, and we're finally on the board. Depending on how this game turns out, that could be the play of the game. This kick going to be fielded by Texas, which is a terrible idea because they're going to have bad field position, and they wasted a few of their precious seconds. They've got 11 to go. We don't want to allow them to get into field goal range, but I don't want them throwing up a long bomb touchdown. So we will just go in the man up three deep. They're going to hand the ball off up the middle. And I believe they'll let this clock run out so we can go into the locker rooms. Only down three, but getting the ball to start the third quarter. It's really just our offense not contributing enough early and our defense struggling on third downs. If we can shore up one of those two problems, I think we can win this game. The defense, except for those third downs, has done a phenomenal job getting stops. So many tackles for loss on first down, setting the Longhorns up for a difficult series, but they just managed to keep converting. So let's turn that around. Let's stop throwing interceptions. Let's win this national championship game. How great would it be if Marquise took this one back? I feel like if I keep saying it, it'll eventually happen. It's not too deep into the end zone, so definitely a fieldable ball, and the blocking is fantastic. Marquise, so long as there aren't any penalties, is off to the race. His 47's not going to be quick enough, and Marquise gives us the lead on the 102-yard kick return to the house. 10 seconds into this third quarter, and we are up 4 points just like that. That blocking to open up the edge is some of the best that I think I've seen all season. So our special teams unit came to play. Let's just not let Texas run it right back. It's a decent stop for us to keep them inside the 25. And there is a lot less pressure on us now. You know, we're in a chance where if we just start trading touchdowns, we could win it No problem. Again, another great first down stop as they try to run it up the middle. Kind of going to sell out to try and stop the pass on this play. Although I wouldn't be surprised. No, this is going to be a run. No, it's a play action. Somebody's got to be open. It's a screen. There's too much movement. We get the stop. It's third and long again. Unfortunately for us, we know exactly how this is going to go. We have not been good containing these third and longs. They ran a mid-draw there? Okay, Texas went into the locker rooms and did something stupid. Maybe they were just banging their heads on the lockers because they have come out with some really low IQ plays. Our defense finds a way to hold on the first drive from Texas in this half. And now Marquise, who just scored two touchdowns for us in record time, gets a chance maybe to take another one. On the punt, it's fielded. Ah, the blocking. The one guy, number 47, the speedster, that needed to be blocked goes unblocked and he gets the good tackle. Regardless, though, we have good field position at the 40-yard line with a chance to extend this lead either to a full touchdown or maybe up to 10 or 11 points, I guess it would be, as we run up the middle and CJ Beasley back in with that bruised ankle gets 5 yards. We will maybe take a little bit of a risk here and step back to pass on second down. I'm going to go with the quick throw to Chad Bradshaw, but he didn't get nearly as much as I had hoped. We are definitely in four down territory now at the 48-yard line. If we don't convert this on third down, we'll go for it. But on third and three, a run up the middle, and CJ Beasley has more than enough for it. And we can just keep marching down the field here. Big, big plays coming in the national championship game. We'll step back to pass, and B was kind of open. Oh my gosh, Marquise came down with that. We threw that almost exact same route in the last game, and it was a pick. This time it's good for 6 yards. Just had some terrifying flashbacks, though, to the Penn State game. I thought for sure that was our third interception of the game. Thankfully, we're still alive. Brayden Bennett gets us to a third and one. And I'm not so certain that we are in field goal range yet, so still four down territory in my mind, and we will just give it to the running back, CJ Beasley, and let him barely pick up the first down. We've struggled with play actions in the past. This could be a big one. We'll see. Try to see how the defense shifts. We're going to run the play, not bringing much pressure. And I got to get outside the pocket. Y may be open. X was kind of open, but let's just take the easy 11 or 12 yards on the scramble and slide down. These playoffs have just made me feel very uncomfortable when running those play actions. I keep getting terrified we're about to take a massive sack, so I've been pretty much just running immediately. It's been working, though. CJ Beasley using the blocks, bouncing it out to the edge, and getting 9 yards of his own. That one just about doubles his rushing yards on the game, as we will look to pass. Marquise out on the right. Not quite going to have the one-on-one that I wanted, but I'm throwing that. Yeah, he's open. They're not going to be able to stop him. That's a first and goal at the 3-yard line. And a chance now to increase it to a 2-score lead here. We're going to go up the middle on first and goal to CJ Beasley. The blocking, not quite there, but he's able to keep the legs moving. And he gets 2 yards out of the play. And now that we're within those 2 yards, Texas knows exactly what play's coming. Can they stop it? The JJ Barr fullback dive up the middle. And he just absolutely trucked the safety. That is too easy. Too easy for JJ. 21-10 late in the third quarter. The way this game started with the Longhorns going up 10-0 had me very worried, but it's been 21 unanswered for the Teal Boys as we have just found a way to respond with a lot of intensity. Definitely going to see Texas start to get a little bit more desperate as every second ticks off the clock. They're going to go with the play action on this one, and Sandcastle is going to get called for a pass interference. That's on me. Tried to jump the route, ran into the man. And we give him, well, they say 25 yards. Is that 15 from the spot? I don't know. Immediately, Texas is now at the 40-yard line. Make a man go in motion. This is going to be a run. It's a counter. Cuts it up the middle. And oh my gosh, the broken tackles are incredible. He gets an incredible block as well. And that's going to be a massive touchdown. AJ Gilliam, what a run, and some downfield blocking. Absolutely beautiful. Texas finds a way to respond very quickly. It's back to just a 4-point lead for us. Well, I mean, the positive of that is that we get to return the ball again, but I don't like how little time came off the clock on that drive. Blocking, pretty solid there, but forced us to kind of lose our momentum to get around it, so just a mediocre return by Marquise's standards. I am definitely in favor of this clock running out, but we're going to pass on first down and hope for the best. A's wide open. Logan Mauldin makes a man miss. I was ready to truck, so we kind of stumbled down, but we're almost at midfield just like that. That is phenomenal. They are bringing a lot of pressure here. I'm a little bit too scared to take in the sack to pass, so we're just going to allow the pressure to come and run, and we still lose yards. I was hoping we could get a couple there, but we lose one. My unwillingness to audible has cost us a couple of times the past few games. It looks like they want to bring pressure again here. Has me a little bit worried. Oh my gosh, that's a lot of pressure. Go with the quick throw out to Logan Mauldin. Take a couple of yards. It's 3rd and 6 now. But again, as far as I'm concerned, this is 4-down territory. We're going to get this play off the final play of the third quarter. It's bounced towards the edge, and the running back, Braden Bennett's wide open. He actually holds onto the ball, and Braden Bennett down the sideline into the end zone as the third quarter comes to a close. We are going to reestablish the 11-point lead. And man, I get worried throwing to him, but hauls it in that time and uses the jets to get away from the defense and find the end zone for 6. So at the end of 3, we're looking really, really good at, what was that, a 21-point third quarter for the Teal Boys. If the defense gets one more stop, this might be over. 6 minutes of gameplay to go. Curious to see, can we finish the job? Texas certainly not out of it. We've seen that they have big play potential. We just need to make sure we're getting our tackles. Play nice, sound defense here. Burn a lot off the clock, if nothing else. I'll be expecting probably a pass on this first down, but I wouldn't be surprised if they hand it off to the man who's run so well. It is a play action. Man's open. I was late to get there, so they're going to pick up a solid chunk of yards there. 7 on the play. I've been bringing the pressure quite a bit. We're going to dial it up on this one. This is a very dangerous play for the defense to run. It is an option out towards the edge, and Cale Mackey gets there immediately. They're going to lose 4, so it's now a 3rd and long. And a chance for the defense to really, really set us up for a beautiful chance at victory. On this 3rd down, what can we do? Expecting the pass, they will step back. Nothing stupid like a screen. They throw over the middle, and we're there with Will Phillips to get the immediate hit. It's 4th and 3. They might go for it. And it is the Longhorns offense that takes the field, so a chance for the turnover on downs. But the defense has to be very committed. We've seen this play multiple times. It's the quarterback run, and he's actually going to get it. Plenty of space that time. His most successful run of the night. It's 28 yards. Our 3rd down defense continues to hurt, and the 4th down hurts us that time. And now they're still alive. 2 broken tackles. Thankfully, somebody else gets there to wrap up. Tony McBride. At this point, for me, the biggest positive is that the clock really just keeps burning. This one, a run up the middle. Plenty of space to work with. Need to get the tackle, and we do. It'll temporarily stop the clock with 4:21 left on it. Defense needs to find something. They're in field goal range, but I think Texas almost needs a touchdown at this point. This time the quarterback keeps it again, but he's not getting anything. A loss of 2, 2nd and 12. I think our boys have done just about enough on this drive. If we give up a touchdown, I can't be too upset. Over 2 minutes of this quarter have been burned away. They're going to go with the slip screen. I don't know if we're going to be there in time. No, we will. Tackled inbounds. 3rd and long again with the clock moving. So can we get the stop on 3rd down and make them go for it on 4th? Bringing the safety blitz. Smith taking a long time to get there. Over the middle, they've got Moses. And it's a 1st and goal now for Texas. I'm bringing the exact same blitz. Again, though, it's going to take too long. I got to back out. Mackey caught there. I don't know how he hit the ball. I don't know how he didn't intercept it, but he does deflect it. That'll give us a 2nd and goal to work with. We're going to bring a little bit of pressure off the edge. This is going to be a run, isn't it? They do hand it off out towards the edge. Will Phillips gets the tackle. He has been so good so far this game. Stops him at the line of scrimmage. And now on third and six, we're going to bring the corner blitz of all things. See if we can get Franklin in. Pressure coming off the edge. Not there. They go over the middle. They find Troy O'Mary. I can't say that name. It picks up positive yards, but it's now fourth and goal from basically the goal line. Can we get the stop? We're bringing some pressure. Looks like they're throwing the screen, and it's a turnover on downs. We're able to get to the quarterback as he's throwing. Terrible decision to throw the screen in that one, but it works. And that might have been the best thing that the defense could have done. The full bend but don't break, as they allow Texas to drive down the field and burn a ton of time off the clock. And now we have a lot of space to try to do the same. Fullback dive on first down to avoid the safety. And we've broken 6,000 offensive yards as a team this season. And we are safely now at the 6-yard line, where we're going to go with the read option. 2 minutes and 19 seconds left in this game. We're up 2 scores. We can almost taste victory. Texas takes their first timeout. It has been a long time coming. But finally, could we win the national championship? We've had such a great season. We came in as the number one seed in the playoffs as Texas takes their second timeout. And now it's 2nd and 9, 2 minutes and 10. Just going to continue to run the ball, force them to use those timeouts so that even if we don't pick up this third down conversion, they just are really struggling for time. And it might be smart to pass here to ensure that we have a better chance of picking up the third down, but I need the clock to be moving, so it'll be a counter to Braden Bennett. The blocking isn't going to be there. Good stop from Texas as they drop us for a loss, but we're going to be able to burn 40 more seconds off the clock before punting it away. We've kind of already cheesed out one punt. Could we do it again? I wouldn't be against it. Minute and a half left in this game. Ball bounces past the return man, which means even more time coming off the clock, and we got him a little bit further downfield. The Longhorns have 1:21 and no timeouts, and they're down 11. A field goal is not on the cards, I would say, for the Longhorns. Unless they score a touchdown and go for 2 early, which is probably the best play. They're going to throw off their back foot, and Don Riley drops the game-winning interception. The coverage was phenomenal, but he just can't quite hold on to it. So it's 2nd and 10. Longhorns stay alive, looking to throw over the middle. We're there with Will Phillips, who can't get the tackle early, but Riley is there to bring him down. The clock moving now. Every second that ticks off is another second closer to victory for us. Under a minute now on this third down. They're going to go with the slip screen. Will Phillips should be there. He can't get the tackle. Don Riley was getting blocked. Aaron Jenkins can't do it. It's going to take Cale Mackey to knock him down, and they get the first down. Not only that, but they got out of bounds to stop the clock. Oh, the Longhorns not saying quit on this one. Looks like it could be this run out towards the edge. The quarterback's keeping it on the option. We're going to tackle him short of the line again, so again, the clock will be moving. I have no idea what their decision-making is here. You have to be passing the ball. It's there. They have to spike it to stop the clock. 36 seconds left. And it's 3rd and 3. Oh my gosh, this is too intense. It feels like we should have the win, but we know that Texas can score quickly. The last thing I want is to give up something disastrous. And there's a quick one over the middle. That'll get 15 yards and stop the clock while they move the chains. I'm expecting kind of a deep pass here. We're going to go cover 4 for a play. And no, they spike the ball with 27 left on the clock. One more tackle inbounds short of the first down line might be enough to just call it victory secured. 2nd and 10, they step back looking to throw. Coverage is going to do just that. 20 seconds and counting. It's 3rd and 2. I'm expecting them just to spike the ball, but there's no time left. Texas, even if they get a touchdown on this next play, I don't think they have enough time to score 2. On top of all of that, it is 4th down. So an incompletion ends the game. They're going to go with a handoff, and that's turnover on downs. What is the decision-making from the Longhorns? Whoever the coach is needs to be fired. Threw away their chance, and now Radon and the Teal Boys can come out and take the knee and burn the remaining 9 seconds out on the national championship game. And with the clock expiring, it'll be your Teal Boys that will be able to raise the trophy. 15-1 on the season. They finally get it done. It's been a really, really long time coming. Oh, man. Play of the game. Is this going to be the throw to Marquise? It is. And we got to watch it in its entirety. A beautiful step back, and he's off to the races. Nobody's going to be able to catch that man. And he's going to most likely come back next season. Oh, man. And we have a couple of surprises in store for next season as well. The confetti is falling. We've made our run through the playoffs. And it's Coastal Carolina who defeat Texas to win the national championship game. And there it is, the crystal ball. Not really the trophy they use anymore, but that's us raising it up. You better believe that's going to be used in the thumbnail. There's the newspaper. What a beautiful celebration. Oh my goodness. All of this thanks to the CFB revamp mod as well. Just a fantastic game. And your final is 28-17. Chanticleers poised maybe to run it back next year. I should have been wearing a heart rate monitor for that game because certainly it was elevated. Texas outgained us in every aspect. They had more first downs. They ran for more yards. They passed for more yards. They had more time of possession. They had fewer turnovers. They created more turnovers. The only thing that the Longhorns didn't do more of is score points. And our special teams continues to be incredible as we win it 28-17. Players of the game, they got to give it to Marquise Jackson. 3 receptions for 84 yards. And he had that massive touchdown reception and the kickoff return for a touchdown. Will Phillips is our defensive player of the game. I think I agree with that. I call his name a lot. 10 tackles, 2 of them for a loss. Just absolutely beautiful. Not an easy game to win, but we come away with the W. And there it is. The CFP National Championship, our 4th trophy of the season. We won the ACC. We won the Orange Bowl. We won the Rose Bowl. And now the Natty is ours. Oh, absolutely fantastic. You love to see it. So now we can complete the final step of the playoffs in the utility tool, which is finalizing them. And so for the final time, we load in the file. And there it is. Oh, champions. You're Teal Boys. I gotta save a screenshot. Absolutely beautiful. We went through Auburn. We rematched against Penn State. And then we were able to take out the Longhorns. I think we had a pretty difficult path. I think, first round matchups, if we're looking at a lower seed, maybe USC or Nebraska could have been more difficult than Auburn, but Auburn was still 99 overall, right? And Penn State, definitely a difficult second round matchup. Definitely would have been much more difficult than playing the Bulls of USF. And then Texas getting their win in their rematch. That was just a really, really solid playoffs all around. So we will save that. And now we can go back. And coming now to the bowl results, we can see all of our wins against Auburn. The score at the bottom is the one that makes sense, right? 15-3. Not all the way at the top of the screen. And then the Rose Bowl win against Penn State, 42-14 was a slaughter. And then 28-17 against the Longhorns. Just a beautiful run through the playoffs. Each game felt pretty different to me. So we will advance here to the end of the bowl season. Let's check out the rest of the bowl games, and then we'll just advance to the end of the season and call it good for this episode. Ooh, through all of that, I guess it makes sense. We get another level up on the head coaching, so that's fantastic. Did we break any records? Marquise sets a school season receiving record at 1,285 yards. Sidney McRae sets a school career sack record at 27 sacks. That's incredible. Those are the only two. Surprisingly enough, we do end the season, believe it or not, as the number one overall team. And of course, before we go into the offseason, let's make sure that we get this letter of intent to level 2. Get those extra 1,500 points for our offseason recruiting, because I know it's been a while since we've had to recruit going through all this offseason stuff, but we have one of the best classes ever coming in. So let's go ahead and go down to our bowl results and just we'll scroll through everything and see how it all played out. We really only care about a lot of the big ones. Wisconsin beats NC State. That's an interesting one. Georgia Southern ends the season with a win against Arkansas, and they end the season as the number three team in the country. A big Gasparilla Bowl winner there. Washington beats Boise State. What other crazy stuff do we have going on here? Let's see, Iowa gets a win. Clemson beats UCLA in the Holiday Bowl. Notre Dame wins another one. They end top 10, so that looks good. The Beavers lose to Bowling Green. You love to see it. LSU wins. Houston wins. The Ducks, you know, bounce back after a rough season to beat BYU in the Red Box Bowl. Cal manages to sneak past Kansas. Louisville unsurprisingly beats Rutgers. Arizona blows out Boston College. Illinois beats South Carolina in a pretty big one. Texas A&M with a win. Penn State won their first playoff match. Miami's able to beat Georgia. That's really good, partially for our recruiting, but also for the conference rankings. Purdue beats Ole Miss. And that's the one that I was really interested in. West Virginia, the Mountaineers are able to beat Michigan in the Citrus Bowl 38-35, and they actually end the season as the number two team in the country. So we got an interesting 1-2-3 of Coastal Carolina, West Virginia, and then Georgia Southern. We'll take a look at the rankings just after this. Florida beats Florida State. That's a big, big matchup in the Gator Bowl. I mean, of course, the Gators are going to win that. That's just kind of unfair. But all around, a beautiful, beautiful playoffs. And the last couple of bowl games, let's see, Mizzou beats Navy, Kent State beats Arkansas State, and the one that matters, 42-14, but actually, it was 28-17. You know, a couple of problems with the mod, but it works, and we get our win, 15-1. Beautiful. Let's go ahead and take one last look at the top 25 polls here. We can see us, West Virginia, Georgia Southern, Texas drops down a spot to 4, USF goes to 5, Oklahoma, Clemson, Penn State, Purdue, and Notre Dame rounds out the top 10. Very interesting. Any teams that seem out of place here? Kind of unexpected. North Texas, yeah. Okay, I would say the Mean Green being 10-4 and ending the season ranked is kind of a surprise, but other than that, maybe Georgia Southern is the most surprising one. Great season for the Eagles, especially for an 83 overall Sun Belt team. But it's the former Sun Belt team and us that... Oh, I just can't get over it. I'm so happy. Unfortunately, though, as happy as I am, that's going to have to be the end of this episode. If you guys enjoyed it, if you're hyped for the Teal Boys Natty win, please hit the like button. Feel free to subscribe, and then of course head to the description, you know, follow me on Twitch at twitch.tv/goonmaster, hit us with the Twitter follow and join the community Discord, and then there's a link down there as well for the College Football Revamped mod if you're trying to do something like this for yourself. We got some fun stuff planned for next season, so stay tuned for that one. But again, thank you so much for watching. My name is Goonmaster. You guys are the national championship winning Teal Boys. And wherever you are, have a good night or have a good morning. And we'll see you later. Adios.